after you're hitting your G flat 5, you're gonna go down to the D flat 5 again that we did earlier. Right? Very simply, you're here at the G flat 5. Move both fingers towards you. Move them up the neck. You're still on the fourth fret, except as opposed to being on your fourth string and third string, now you are on your fifth string and fourth string on the fourth fret. We're going from here to here. Let's put it together. One more time. Let's get you back to the beginning of the phrase, and you'll see how it's starting to make sense. Almost there. Now, from this position, which is your D flat 5, we're going to go back up to the E flat 5 on your sixth fret. Now, we already went over that chord, so I'm going to start simplifying things a little bit. We just got here. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Hit it four times. Then you're going to go back down again to your D flat 5. What do I mean? That's what I meant before when I said breaking it down in chunks. You want to try and take chunks of the song and build on them. It's going to be very difficult for you to learn this in one or two shots, so be patient. Again, in chunks. One, two, three, four, one. Okay? Back at the D flat 5, after which we will follow it with the following. Back to your G flat 5 as learned before. So, your G flat 5, your E 5, then your B 5, which is built here on the fifth string, second fret. Same fingers. So, what's the phrase? Ending on your D 5. Let's put it all together. Now, once we get through this part, we're going to move on to the verses, which is the melodic breakdown. It's very simple but effective chord progression, and I think this will be a little bit easier for both of us. First, I'm going to give you the chords. Take off the distortion. Step on your distortion box if you have one. If your amp has a built-in distortion setting, you probably have that little switch box which lets you take it on and off. That's what I just did here, even though I think it's out of camera range. So now we have our clean sound. Wow, sounds pretty good. Love these Epiphone guitars. Okay, your first chord is going to be a G minor, followed by an F, a C, and a C minor. I'm doing these all within 3 frets of each other. I'm not going to be going up and down the neck. On the recording, there's three, four guitars doing this part. I'm trying to simplify it for you. Obviously, you're not going to be able to do all the guitar parts at once, so I'm trying to sort of pick out the dominant parts for you. Okay, I think we left off on the C minor. Then you're going to go to the G minor again, to the F. G minor, F, F again, C, C minor, G minor, F. Now, immediately following this, you're going to do this, I think they do it three or four times, and the verse continues to flow like that. And then the tempo picks up, using the same chords, but a slightly different progression. Take a look. Your first chord will be a G minor. Second chord will be an F. The F continues to hold, then it goes to a G minor. See if we can put that together. You're going to do that three times. After concluding that part, you'll go to a C, then you'll go to an F, and every now and then you want to throw in the sus. It's an F sus, which will go. Basically, you'll be taking your pinky and flattening it over the fourth string, unless, I think it's a little more complicated, but if you want to go, which is basically taking your second, third, and fourth finger and putting it over here on your third fret to create the sus chord. I think it's a little easier just to flatten your pinky as I was doing. So, let's tie it together. The chords will go like this. Just repeat it again. F, back to G minor. Right? After the guitar solo, it goes again to that slow part, which is based around G minor. You already know these chords, especially if you know the song, you know what I'm talking about. I'll give it to you real quick. D D D D D D D D D D D D D D D D D D D D. You've got the song. After which, as you know, it goes back to the beginning, where it goes sitting on a park bench. It goes back to the beginning of the song. You click on your distortion. Got your distortion ready, the quiet part finished, and you go.
Sitting on a park bench, eyeing little girls with bad intents. Snot running down his nose.
Okay, so now it goes through that entire beginning phrase all over again. Then the following verse leads to the finale, which goes as follows. Then the drums do their solo one more time, and then you follow it with G flat 5, E flat 5, F major. So what are the three chords? G flat 5, E flat 5, F major. So at the end he goes, oh, Aqualung. That's when the bombs go off and everybody starts screaming and lighting lighters and all that fun stuff. Now listen, there's a lot to remember and a lot to practice, but you can do it. Good luck and good playing.